Hi, my name is Mary Pendergast. I'm an ecologist working with Sageland Collaborative, and I'm here today to talk to you about the boreal toads and the Aquatic and Amphibian Habitat Assessment Project. I, like many other people, fell in love with amphibians and reptiles as a small child because you can access them usually in a lot of different places and catch them as a kid, and I've just always been fascinated, particularly with amphibians. It's like Christmas every time you find one. So we are still in the field season of the eighth year of what we fondly call the Boreal Toad or Aquatic Habitat Assessment Project. And we have had community scientists helping us gather data on the landscape about habitat conditions as well as breeding populations of boreal toads every year.
Okay, my name is Kayleigh Mullen and I'm the Utah Conservation Program Supervisor here at Hogle Zoo. I've been here 4.5 years now, and one of my major projects I'm working on is the Boreal Toad Project. So I've always wanted to work with amphibians since my undergrad, and I started researching their genetics back over in England. So then I went on to do my master's in connectivity, and I wanted to do a genetics project in boreal toads, but I couldn't find enough boreal toads to do the research. And then it just launched me here to the zoo, where I get to survey for boreal toads, I get to go to all these beautiful habitats and locations, and I get to take volunteers with me, which is a part of the job I really, really enjoy. We have a breeding program. So we were successful in breeding boreal toads this summer for the first time, and we actually got to release 64 toadlets, which is a real word, down onto the Ponsagunt Plateau. That was kind of a big career highlight for me.
So one of the things I think it's important for us to recognize, particularly in Utah, where we are experiencing drought quite often, and we see the shrinking of the footprint where we have water, as well as the shrinking of the duration when we have standing water, that is an indicator for a lot of the struggles that we have here in the arid West. And boreal toads and other amphibians are some of the first responders to those changes. So I think it's really important that we keep an eye on amphibians and how those populations are doing, whether they're still viable, if we're experiencing declines, because they're really showing us what's to come.
They're really important just in the ecosystem in general. They're one of the few animals that fully lives life in an aquatic environment and a terrestrial environment. So in the ecosystem, they play a really important role in kind of nutrient cycling across that aquatic terrestrial barrier. And they're also great pest control. Amphibians are kind of facing this cocktail of stresses: climate change, habitat loss and destruction, habitat fragmentation, and then chytrid fungus is a really big issue for them.
It's not harmful in any way to humans, but it spreads to amphibians very rapidly in some cases and can cause death and in populations fairly rapidly. So what I would love to see in some of these ecosystems we're working in to make sure that breeding habitat for amphibians remains in quality condition and that those populations remain viable in perpetuity would really just require some pretty simple things: maintaining water quality and quantity throughout the breeding season, and making sure that those aquatic habitats are connected.
I hear people saying, you know, when I was a kid, I heard frogs everywhere. I always used to see boreal toads, but now I don't see them. I can't show my kids that kind of aspect of nature. So I think it's important for people to care so we can kind of bring that connection to nature back.
So if you want to participate in the Boreal Toad Project and Amphibian Habitat Assessments, you can sign up at Sageland Collaborative. We have a project page for boreal toads and amphibians, and you can participate at varying levels: single-day trips, multi-day camping, or you can do independent field trips where you just take a field form with you when you go out hiking.